This is going to be the perfect funnel that's going to help you launch your own online event, live webinar, and online masterclass using GoHighLevel software alone without any third-party software. So you can go ahead and cancel all those third-party subscriptions and save yourself some bucks. This is for online coaches, consultant, or trainer, or really just anyone who do daily challenge or looking to connect with their audience live. Let's jump to the computer screen here. I'm going to show you the mind map so you can see the overview of the snapshot first, and then we're going to switch between this mind map and the GoHighLevel account to actually show you the real setup. So we're going to start off with the funnel, and the funnel have two pages, which is the opt-in page, and this is where you promote. It's going to have some headline and some graphics to get people enticed, and normally grab people phone number, email, address. Obviously you can add more field in the form, right? Once people opt in, they're going to go to the thank you page. Now, the special automation that we have set up is that once they opt in, you want to share that notification with your guests, right? If you were doing it with a guest, in my case, I do. And then your guests are going to get notified, including you and your team as well. And obviously, the lead will get confirmation that they've been registered for this event. Once they land on the thank you page, we're going to hit them with the reminder notification. This is very similar to appointment reminder, where they get confirmed in their email, you've been registered, and this is the event dates and time. And then they will get SMS and email reminder when the time come and due. The thing that we have in the thank you page and in the email as well is that we want to actually lead them to some sort of a community or a group. In our case, we use school. If you want to check that out, we have a 14-day trial below. Really, you can just do WhatsApp group, right? Or some kind of Facebook groups. As long as people gather into one group, and then you can post update on the event afterward, for example, call recording or Q&A. And then we actually going to use community broadcast, which is the feature inside the community to remind people on that specifically event at that time, okay? And afterward, we want to be tagging people in our GoHighLevel saying this guy come to this event, and then we want to export that file in CSV file, and then we want to share that with the guests. Most of the guests that I talk to, they want to have a list of people that actually attend the event, because what we normally do is that we're doing a cross promotion. When we have the event, I promote it to my list and my audience, and the guests promote it to their list and their audience. You don't have to do this. This is very optional, but we normally like to share the list with the guests of the attendee. Let's move on to what's actually happened inside GoHighLevel. If you head over to site, and you can see in this snapshot, there's only one funnel that called a webinar funnel, and you want to go ahead and click on that. As you can see here, this funnel have two steps. We even give you two variations to split test in the opt-in page, because that is very important, white background and black background. Let's just show you this one first. And then after people opt in, we actually lead them to the thank you page. Okay, this is what the opt-in is. We haven't integrated the form yet, but obviously there's a form right here. There's no button. There's just a form where people scroll down, then they can put their own email, phone number, and full names and all that stuff. What we have here, guys, very simple. We just have the headline and the graphics design, and then we have the time conversion, okay? Don't worry, we'll tell you how to set all this up. And once they opt in, they're gonna go to this thank you page that say, check your spam email and join our community for further update. We even, do a screenshot on how to navigate our school community, which is go to calendar and then add this event straight to the calendar. Data shows that if you encourage someone to add the event into their calendar, they are more likely to show up and not forget your webinar. And just keep in mind, guys, doesn't matter how good your marketing is, people all have their own life. They have kids, they have family, they have food, they have job, they have other commitments. You want to do your best in terms of reminding them and making sure that this is become really repetitive in their eyes so that they show up, okay? Yeah, we just show them how to actually save the event, but obviously once people get into school, they're gonna get hit with our posts and our nurturing content as well. So it's worked both ways. So right now what we have gone over is the opt-in page, the thank you page, the school community, and the community broadcast. Obviously in school, there's a feature to actually blast an email and notification to all of your member. Unfortunately, you only can use that for 72 hours. But yeah, again, you want to time that blast to your event really well. So make sure that you don't use this blast too early or too late. Okay. Obviously, you don't have to use Google guys. Like Facebook have this feature. I think WhatsApp also have this feature, and Discord also have this feature as well. It's just different how those platforms notify your audience. So the next thing that I want to cover is the automation. If you head over to automation, there's only one workflow here. It's called webinar registration workflow, and we'll just show you what's inside the workflow builder. As you can see here, guys, the workflow trigger based on the form submit. So when someone submit the opt-in page, they get add tag. It could be any tag you want. It sends Slack notification channel. It sends notification to our team. Again, it sends notification to our guests. And here what we have is actually a custom field, okay? So this is the guest email, and we're going to teach you how to modify and literally set up the snapshot in like 2 minutes. So watch till the end, okay? And then we'll send the confirmation email, say your registration has been confirmed, and then we just give them all of the time zone, right? We normally have Bangkok time, which is where I'm at, London, Eastern Standard Time for America, US time, and then Eastern Australian Standard Time for Australia. All right, we just have like a couple of time zones where most people seem to locate, at least for our audience. So you want to match that time zone option to where your audience mostly locate at. And then it wait 5 minutes, and then it send them also another SMS as well. Now, the part for this is that unlike appointment reminder campaign, you need to set the date and the event time, right? So if the event happening in this time or whatever time, you want to set that time, and it has to be your local time zone. So if the event happened in whatever US time zone, it doesn't matter. You have to set it in your local time zone, which is the location, like this account time zone. If you staying in Thailand, it has to be this Thailand time zone, like this Thai time zone, if that makes sense at all. So it's very important because the reminder will follow that specific event date and time. So once you actually set that up, the email reminder and SMS reminder will just follow that event time and date. And we also have one here after 15 minutes. So after the event starts for 15 minutes, we're gonna tell everyone, say, hey, we're gonna close the Zoom room. We're gonna close this online class. So you can't join anymore with this link. And it's normally get people to click quickly. And that's it. We give two reminders before the event and one reminder 15 minutes after the event. Again, because everyone here is tag guy, you're going to be able to send the entire list to your guests without sending everything, okay? Only the people that register in this event. So let's move on to setting. And you wanna head over to custom value. And you can see here, everything is in custom value. Even the graphics will actually get you to upload it into the media storage and paste the link here. And you can see here, you can change the headline. You can change each of the time zone. If the event is happening in whatever time, you just have to go to Google and get that time converter and change it to whatever time you want, okay? And that will reflect it on here, okay? So if you change it to 9 p.m. BKK time, which is stand for Bangkok time here, it will reflect in here. So yeah, you just have to change it. And most importantly, you want to change the headline, and you want to update this event location, which is the meeting link. This is going to be the link that the system going to be sent out to everyone when the time comes. So make sure that this link is correct, otherwise people will not show up because they're not going to be there, okay? So basically, guys, this is a very basic snapshot. We have 3 videos in total that will show you how to set it up, which is setting up the snapshot and then update the webinar banner, which is to do with graphics. So what we do is that, you know, in the SOP, we have a Canva link that you can click here, right? Once you click, it will lead you to this template link. You can go to file and make a copy. Once you make a copy, it will auto transfer to your Canva account. If you don't have Canva, just make one, and then you could just edit it, just put your face in here, put your guest in here. Now if you don't have a guest, just have one face in there and just edit the date. It's very easy to do, and then you can download the image into PNG file, and then you can come back to your GoHighLevel account, you upload it to the media storage, which is in here, and then you grab the link and then you put it into the custom value. Again, right, this is very fast, guys. If you don't know how to do it, we actually have a training to show you how to set all of this up. And we even have an extra module where we show you how to create an event on school so that people can go into your school community, can add it to their calendar, and remember to show up. It's a complete setup because we like to go the extra mile. If you have any other question, make sure that you drop it down in the comment below. I'll make sure to reply that personally. I check that every day. If you're watching it this far, make sure that you check the link in the description to see how you can get access to this snapshot for completely free. If you guys like this video, make sure that you share it with another GoHighLevel ninja. Otherwise, I'll see you on the next one. Hey guys, if you enjoy watching the video, make sure that you also checking out this content right there.